The moose. The moose in North America, or elk in Eurasia, Alces alces, is a member of the New World deer subfamily and is the largest and heaviest extant species in the deer family. Most adult male moose have distinctive broad, palmate, open-hand-shaped antlers. Most other members of the deer family have antlers with a dendritic, twig-like configuration. Moose typically inhabit boreal forests and temperate broadleaf and mixed forests of the northern hemisphere in temperate to subarctic climates. Hunting and other human activities have caused a reduction in the size of the moose's range over time. It has been reintroduced to some of its former habitats. Currently, most moose occur in Canada, Alaska, New England, with Maine having the most of the lower 48 states, New York State, Fennoscandia, the Baltic states, and Russia. Its diet consists of both terrestrial and aquatic vegetation. The most common predators of the moose are wolves, bears, and humans. Unlike most other deer species, moose do not form herds and are solitary animals, aside from calves who remain with their mother until the cow begins estrus, typically at 18 months after birth of the calf, at which point the cow chases them away. Although generally slow-moving and sedentary, moose can become aggressive, and move quickly if angered or startled. Their mating season in the autumn features energetic fights between males competing for a female. Description and anatomy. Bull moose have antlers like other members of the deer family. Cows select mates based on antler size. Bull moose use dominant displays of antlers to discourage competition and will spar or fight rivals. The size and growth rate of antlers is determined by diet and age. Symmetry reflects health. The male's antlers grow as cylindrical beams projecting on each side of the head at right angles to the midline of the skull, and then fork. The lower prong of this fork may be either simple, or divided into two or three tines, with some flattening. Most moose have antlers that are broad and palmate, flat, with tines, points, along the outer edge. Within the ecologic range of the moose in Europe, those in northerly locales display the palmate pattern of antlers, while the antlers of European moose over the southerly portion of its range are typically of the Cervina dendritic pattern and comparatively small, perhaps due to evolutionary pressures of hunting by humans, who prize the large palmate antlers. European moose with antlers intermediate between the palmate and the dendritic form are found in the middle of the north-south range. Moose with antlers have more acute hearing than those without antlers. A study of trophy antlers using a microphone found that the palmate antler acts as a parabolic reflector, amplifying sound at the moose's ear. The antlers of mature Alaskan adult bull moose, 5 to 12 years old, have a normal maximum spread greater than 200 centimeters. By the age of 13, moose antlers decline in size and symmetry. The widest spread recorded was 210 centimeters across. An Alaskan moose also holds the record for the heaviest weight at 36 kilograms. After the mating season, males drop their antlers to conserve energy for the winter. A new set of antlers will then regrow in the spring. Antlers take 3 to 5 months to fully develop, making them one of the fastest growing animal organs. Antler growth is nourished by an extensive system of blood vessels in the skin covering, which contains numerous hair follicles that give it a velvet texture. This requires intense grazing on a highly nutritious diet. By September, the velvet is removed by rubbing and thrashing, which changes the color of the antlers. Immature bulls may not shed their antlers for the winter, but retain them until the following spring. Birds, carnivores, and rodents eat dropped antlers as they are full of protein, and moose themselves will eat antler velvet for the nutrients. If a bull moose is castrated, either by accidental or chemical means, he will quickly shed his current set of antlers and then immediately begin to grow a new set of misshapen and deformed antlers that he will wear the rest of his life without ever shedding again. The distinctive-looking appendages, often referred to as devil's antlers, are the source of several myths and legends among many groups of Inuit as well as several other tribes of indigenous peoples of North America. In extremely rare circumstances, a cow moose may grow antlers. This is usually attributed to a hormone imbalance. The moose proboscis is distinctive among the living cervids due to its large size. It also features nares that can be sealed shut when the moose is browsing aquatic vegetation. The moose proboscis likely evolved as an adaptation to aquatic browsing, with loss of the ranarium, and development of a superior olfactory column separate from an inferior respiratory column. This separation contributes to the moose's keen sense of smell, which they employ to detect water sources, to find food under snow, and to detect mates or predators. As with all members of the order Artiodactyla, even toed ungulates, moose feet have two large keratinized hooves corresponding to the third and fourth toe, with two small posterolateral dewclaws, vestigial digits, corresponding to the second and fifth toe. The hoof of the fourth digit is broader than that of the third digit, while the inner hoof of the third digit is longer than that of the fourth digit. This foot configuration may favor striding on soft ground. The moose hoof splays under load, increasing surface area, which limits sinking of the moose foot into soft ground or snow, and which increases efficiency when swimming. The body weight per footprint surface area of the moose foot is intermediate between that of the pronghorn foot, which have stiff feet lacking dewclaws, optimized for high-speed running, and the caribou foot, which are more rounded with large dewclaws, optimized for walking in deep snow. The moose's body weight per surface area of footprint is about twice that of the caribou's. On firm ground, a bull moose leaves a visible impression of the dewclaws in its footprint, while a cow moose or calf does not leave a dewclaw impression. On soft ground or mud, bull, cow, and calf footprints may all show dewclaw impressions. Their fur consists of two layers, top layer of long guard hairs and a soft woolly undercoat. The guard hairs are hollow and filled with air for better insulation, which also helps them stay afloat when swimming. Both male and female moose have a dewlap or bell, which is a fold of skin under the chin. Its exact use is unknown, but theories state that it might be used in mating, as a visual and olfactory signal, or as a dominance signal by males, as are the antlers. The tail is short, 6 cm to 8 cm in length, and vestigial in appearance. Unlike other ungulates, the moose tail is too short to swish away insects. On average, an adult moose stands 1.4 to 2.1 meters high at the shoulder, which is more than 1 foot higher than the next largest deer on average, the wapiti. Males, or bulls, normally weigh from 380 to 700 kilograms and females, or cows, typically weigh 200 to 490 kilograms, depending on racial or clinal as well as individual age or nutritional variations. The head and body length is 2.4 to 3.1 meters, with the vestigial tail adding only a further 5 to 12 centimeters. The largest of all the races is the Alaskan subspecies A.A. Gigas, which can stand over 2.1 meters at the shoulder, has a span across the antlers of 1.8 meters and averages 634.5 kilograms in males and 478 kilograms in females. Typically, however, the antlers of a mature bull are between 1.2 meters and 1.5 meters. The largest confirmed size for this species was a bull shot at the Yukon River in September 1897 that weighed 820 kilograms and measured 2.33 meters high at the shoulder. There have been reported cases of even larger moose, including a bull killed in 2004 that weighed 1,043 kilograms, and a bull that reportedly scaled 1,180 kilograms, but none are authenticated and some may not be considered reliable. Behind only the two species of bison, the moose is the second largest of extant terrestrial wildlife after the bisons in North America, Siberia, and Europe. Thanks for watching.